All right. Well, welcome to the Earnest Report for Tuesday. And I'm going to try to do a report here that's a little bit more formal than usual. I actually wrote stuff down. I'm going to try to give as much news as I know about all the way across the pipeline that extends from Memphis, Tennessee, through Arkansas, into Cushing, Oklahoma. And so this might be a little bit of a longer update than usual, and it also might be paired with another update that just goes into a little bit more detail on an upcoming project. First thing I would like to do, and I'll add this link into the notes, is that the recent conference that came out of Oklahoma, for anybody wanting information or to get caught up with what's going on in Oklahoma across the Diamond Pipeline, you should definitely watch this webcast by Kevin Gilbert of the recent conference, and he's actually done several interviews in the area as well, if you want to go into more depth. But this is a great video, a great statement, and I think everybody that's involved with raising the awareness of the Diamond Pipeline and how it affects the people that live in Oklahoma, Arkansas, and Tennessee. I believe everybody can say along this pipeline route that we support everything that's said in that video. With that said, let's get started. So I am Earnest Rando, for those of you who may not know me, and I've been publishing the Earnest Report and the Earnest Goes playlists that I have on YouTube. Earnest Goes to the DNC, Earnest Goes to No Dapple, and now Earnest Goes to Arkansas Rising. And so I do have some YouTube playlist where I post these videos and where I also link to other YouTube videos that I come across regarding the Diamond Pipeline. And that's kind of what I do. After coming back from Standing Rock, spending some time with family, I decided to backpack and move into Arkansas along the Diamond Pipeline route. And I've kind of been traveling along the pipeline in Arkansas, specifically through Northwest Arkansas. And there we go. Sorry. And so learned a lot about the area, learned a lot about the pipeline, learned a lot about the different groups all along the pipeline that are working within their own communities and beginning to work across state boundaries as everybody gets more organized. So I will start with a little watchdog report and basically let folks know that the pipeline crosses lots of public access roads. You are free to just drive around and see where the pipelines cross public roads and where they go through people's farms and environmentally sensitive areas. We recently located and shot a little video at an area where the American burying beetle, a threatened or endangered species, a critically endangered species maybe, but definitely endangered. Habitat is there. One of the interesting things when we went out and looked at the site was that you can actually see, you know, through most of the pipeline route, the whole top soil is kind of pushed to the side and is flattened in most areas. So one of the things in these environmentally sensitive areas is that they actually haven't done that. And many of these areas are publicly accessible in the sense that you can see them from public roads and people's property. No trespassing. And so we will be keeping an eye on that. Lots of people will be keeping an eye on that. There is a county Facebook page for every county along the Diamond Pipeline route. And there are organizations across Facebook that you can post videos to or pictures in your area if you would like. But I just want to let people know that we're identifying and looking visually with our own lines at the construction that the Diamond Pipeline has done. Of course, a lot of this is through people's yards and property and nations, as in Oklahoma. There is a drill moving west out of Memphis, which is where the pipeline ends, so to speak. And there is a drill moving east from Fort Smith area. And it looks like they're preparing for a drill moving west out of Fort Smith, Sebastian County area that will go into Oklahoma, so that there will be three drills going, covering roughly a third. And so there are various groups that are needed and that are watching the drills in the progress, and we hope very soon to make basically a public radio show where a couple times a week we are actually filming, showing you pictures of where the drills are at, and just making, since this pipeline is put in here using eminent domain laws, which says that the pipeline's for the public good, we're going to make sure that the public good is at least observed as much as we can. And we're going to do that hopefully in a very legal, public way, just to let folks know what's happening so they can see what's happening in their backyards. This also includes attending various local groups that are in the area, which I'll get into more detail in a minute. And just raising awareness and education. But I'll talk more about that project later. There are lots of communities getting organized across the pipeline route. There are lots of folks in the Memphis, Tennessee area. There are lots of folks, of course, the Women's March was 5,000-7,000 people in Little Rock, Arkansas the other day. So there's lots of organizations, community organizations, that are organizing for their own community benefit. But of course, this pipeline affects so many communities. It's an easy way to network and tie in and build social relationships that actually strengthen each other's communities. So lots of things happening in Little Rock. Since there's lots of construction going on around the Ozark area, along the pipeline, folks up in the plateau north of Ozark is very active and becoming involved. There's 350.org chapters, there's IWW chapters, there is moveon.org groups, there are Movement for Black Lives Matters groups out here in Little Rock and Oklahoma and Tennessee. So lots of organizations up in the plateau that are wanting to find ways to support folks along the pipeline route. And of course, we have lots of folks in Oklahoma. And I would again stress to watch the conference, because it talks about, the AIM representatives, let's see, what else do we got? Oh, the No Pains Pipeline group and the Bold Oklahoma group, as well as others, were at this conference. So you can find their information out by watching that conference. So a lot of watchdogging going on. Lots of community actions and organizing across the pipeline. Everything from legal and legislative aspects. There's a big climate change lobby groups in the area that are putting pressure through the legislative process. Of course, moveon.org is finding presence within Oklahoma and Arkansas and Tennessee. So those folks are really interested in, you know, getting voices out to legislators, and in particular to local groups. And there are lots of events in resistance, in particularly to the social injustice that we see happening. A lot of this is in the protesting of the Trump administration and the corporate takeover, corporate fascist corporate takeover of our government on the national, state, and local level. So you'll hear a lot of organizations talking about the 10 things that they're going to do within the next first 100 days of Trump's presidency. And so there's lots of events from various social justice aspects to various environmental aspects and economic aspects, all kind of bubbling up within their own communities and reaching across and out to their neighbors. So it's pretty cool. Arkansas Rising has had a couple nonviolent direct action trainings, and there will be another one on February 18th in Little Rock. This will also be preceded by a decolonization training, so it should be a very interesting weekend for folks to participate in. There are a lot. If you want a list of the events that I know of, you can go to my Facebook page, or not my page, but my profile, and you can click on the events and see which ones I'm interested in. I try to keep tabs on as many Facebook events in the local area as possible. I've actually been letting go of some of the information about the Texas and the Florida pipeline because I'm getting plenty of information just about the Diamond Pipeline and also the Bayou Bridge Pipeline in Louisiana. So I'm going to be focusing from now on just those two particular pipelines, with some occasional important updates for other things. But mostly just these two pipelines. So I urge folks to get involved, especially with if you're in Northwest Arkansas, with the Omni Center. Their first week of February, they have 10 different events that I'm going to try to attend. And I'll run through those real quick. So especially for my GoFundMe family, so you guys kind of know what I'm doing and going to be doing the next couple weeks. But in Fayetteville, at or through the Omni Center, of these are basically the events for the first half of February. On the 4th is their annual lasagna dinner, which where I'll be speaking about what's going on with the Diamond Pipeline and the new project coming up. The 5th, there's a climate change book forum and an open mic. On the 6th, there's a civil rights roundtable. On the 7th is a veggie potluck dinner and a climate change lobby discussion group after that. The 9th, there's a peace and justice group meeting. On the 11th, there's a 350.org chapter meeting. On the 12th, there's a Transition Northwest Arkansas meeting, which I'm super excited about, as I've been following the transition movement for several years now. And then, of course, there's a fundraiser in Eureka Springs for Arkansas Rising, and on the 16th of February at Chelsea's, and then our training on the 18th. And I'm starting to even compile. So most of that is in a Google calendar on the Omni Center's page. But I'm going to try to attend as many of those as I can, reach out to those groups, find out how those that are supporting the stopping of the Diamond Pipeline, how we can support what other groups in the community are doing together. So that's what I'll be working on in the next couple weeks. couple more updates. As I said earlier, a really good group if you're in Arkansas and you're wanting to get involved on the legal aspect and the legislative aspect, to get involved with climate change lobby and the Arkansas Water Guardians in Northwest Arkansas. Definitely check out the link to the Oklahoma conference. One of the best ways to communicate with me, you can always leave comments on my GoFundMe page, which I'll leave a link to, or actually this will be in, and also Twitter. Another thing on the communications side of things that I've kind of just been observing and I want to throw out to the general community, is like I'd like to know how many people are familiar with Slack. Could be a great way to organize across the pipeline route. And so I just want to throw that out there as a possibility of happening one of these days. And now if you have any questions about any of that, leave me some comments. This will be on my YouTube channel. This will be on my Facebook feed and my GoFundMe page. Last thing that I want to talk about, and I'll do a separate video of this, is there has been a need in the general community up here and along the pipeline route for more educational awareness about the pipeline, ways to support other events that are happening along the pipeline route in the communities, and for like mobile broadcasting of what's going on with the pipeline and the construction. And so I've actually drafted a proposal for a Stop the Diamond Pipeline bus cooperative. And this is very much in the draft process, but I'm getting it reviewed right now. But I've written up some basic bylaws and guidelines for a cooperative ownership of a short bus that would provide various logistical and volunteer support for a lot of the community events that are going to happen and that are happening along the pipeline. Everything from having a potential kitchen or tables for hosting potlucks, to having office support and broadcasting and video abilities, using just phones, but having the office space to be able to sit down and take video and edit it and then upload it or get it out, as well as being able to move sources along the pipeline, different, cards, flyers, other material, canvassing in neighborhoods, lots of things can be done. So basically I'm going to do another video that goes into detail on what the bus cooperative is, but if you can kind of think of a mobile unit that's traveling along with the drills along the pipeline and basically any community event that happens, that bus would be able to show up there. Sounds like everybody that I've talked to so far likes the idea of potentially drawing a map of the pipeline around the bus, so this bus actually becomes a public educational display to help raise awareness about the pipeline and then quickly move people into community groups in their area so that they can become involved with the community, learn more about the pipeline, and hopefully we can come up with solutions to stop the Diamond Pipeline. So, that is the end of this Earnest report, and I will shoot another video of the bus cooperative And please check out the conference, Oklahoma conference link, and please get involved in your local community groups. Thank you and have a good day.